Hey, what's up, Orange Army? This is UJTV, and of course, I am your boy, Zitembe M. Abangazikahle bathi nginqunqule shaya amaphiko phezulu intaba khala amajoda khala abafazi. Of course, we just crowned our brand new Miss and Mr. UJ APK for the year 2024. So right about now, I'm just going to go around, you know, find the people who are the who's and who's here, the directors, and of course, our winners, to find out how exactly they feel about tonight. Alright, and now here with me, ladies and gentlemen, is your king for the coming year. You're going to be seeing him at public appearances and all. Bayanda, congratulations, man, for being our Mr. UJ APK 2024, the first ever. How do you feel?
I'm still trying to process everything. It's overwhelming. A lot of practice, hard work went into this. So now finally seeing the result and being the first king ever. Yeah, I'm still shocked.
That's quite iconic right there, I will tell you that. Now talk to me about the first thing you're going to be doing as our Mr. UJ APK for the year 2024.
Thank you for the question.
Yes, you'll remember when I was doing my mission statement, I touched on my campaign.
I advocate for and promote that men become part of pageant so they can also share the platform on doing community engagement.
Isaziso campaign, which aims to educate young men about pageants and empowering young black men specifically to enter pageants and encourage them to be part of such platforms.
Oh, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen, your king for the year, Bayanda. Now, the main lady of the evening joining me right here. Her name is Onkemetse. Girl, how are you feeling? You are a brand new Miss UJ APK for the year 2024.
I'm shocked, actually. Like, I don't know how to feel. There's so many emotions. I can't even explain it. It still feels like a dream.
Absolutely, I can understand. But now tell me about the work that went into this. I know you ladies worked very hard. How was the preparation process like going into this competition?
It was very hard, honestly speaking. At some point, I wanted to quit because I felt like the pressure was too much. And also, this is my first pageant. It's something that I've never done before. So for me, it was a whole new thing to me, and I didn't know what not to prepare and what to prepare, but I'm here now because of the hard work and dedication that I put into this.
Absolutely, you are here. And now that you're here for the entire year. Talk to me about all the plans that you want to put to place, of course, as our Miss UJ APK.
The first thing that I plan to put to cross is definitely the UJ Ballroom and Latin Dance Club that caters for all students here at UJ, including students with disabilities. Does not only provide them with dance skills, but it also provides them with essential life skills such as discipline, leadership skills. They are also able to leave the university as confident beings and students. And they can go out there in the corporate world having those skills.
I've got with me stunning Onkemetse.
Hi, Onkemetse. Congratulations for making the 12th pageant. My question to you is, what steps will you take to create a campus environment where every student gains confidence and essential life skills to extra playing exam?
The first step that I will take is to revive the UJ Ballroom and Latin Dance Club. I believe that this is a way that will help students and accommodate each and every student, including the ones with disabilities, to be able to unleash their full potential and confidence, not only getting their skills, but also acquiring essential life skills such as discipline, leadership skills, and being able to lead themselves.
Absolutely loving that. Now, one last question. So many people were supporting you, voting for you, going to a Akalektika page. What do you like to say to everybody who supported you?
I would like to say I am grateful for each and every one of you. I appreciate you all because, yay, I would literally terrorize you guys. Click that link, vote for me, repost and comment on my content. I'm grateful for each and every one of you. Thank you. And I hope that it doesn't end with me. You also do that with the other people. Thank you so much.
And there you have it, ladies and gents. Your Miss UJ APK 2024. Unkemetse.
Nkhumise.
Oh, yes. And of course, now here with me are the family and friends of our brand new queen in 3, 2, 1, Onkemetse! Thank you so much. And now right here with me is a lady who knows all about the blood, the sweat and the effort that went into making tonight possible. Our director, Dibatso Mamabolo. Dibatso, you know it's one thing to have an idea, but when it comes to life like this, tell me exactly how you feel right now.
It feels like a dream come true. It really just feels like all those sleepless nights were worth it. It feels like I was directly involved in making someone's dream a reality. It really feels I can't put it in words.
You can't put it in words, and I can imagine. Now, I know it looks so put together tonight. We're looking beautiful, we're looking stunning, but I know you faced some challenges leading up to tonight. Tell us how you overcame those.
You know, just a general comment on leadership is that you grow every day and you learn new lessons every day. And I have experience in pageant directing, but this year tested me in ways that I never thought were possible. So it's a continuous journey of growth. You should always be willing to grow and to be attentive of what's happening around you.
Absolutely incredible. Those are words coming through from our director for Miss and Mr. UJ APK 2024, Dibatso Mamabolo.
And with every little challenge that we made the finalists do, or everything that went into the entire production, we were very intentional about them leaving this platform with not just the crown, but experience and knowledge that can enrich them going forward into their futures. If anything, this isn't just a pageant. This is a leadership camp. And all of them, in their mission statements, have amplified their advocacy and have shown that the future of South Africa is as bright as ever. Yes. I'd like to thank all of the sponsors that have sponsored the event to be as amazing as it is. We couldn't have done it without all of you. And can you please give them a round of applause? But most importantly, I'd like to give out a vote of thanks to my team. Without them, the entire vision wouldn't come to light. To be honest, I'm a very difficult director. I'm very difficult because if it's in my mind, you have to understand it. And that caused a lot of conflict. But I'm so grateful to them for seeing the vision and executing the vision. I'd like to thank Project Media Lens.
Miss UJ APK 2023, our outgoing queen. Kwandiwe, first of all, before we get any far, this designed by Wabi Kocho, what brief did you give them right there?
I literally said to Wabi, make me the best looking person in this place, and she delivered.
Oh, she delivered indeed. Kwandi, you know, I asked you this question on stage, but I'm going to ask it again. You've learned so much throughout your reign. What is that one thing you want our Mr. and Miss UJ APK to go into this platform taking into mind?
I want them to take into mind the fact that everything they want to achieve is possible. Everything they study and said in their mission statements, you can do it. Don't let the crowd tell you anything. You are chosen for a reason and you will achieve that mission.
We absolutely love that girl. You look stunning and we wish you all the best ahead with your journey. Gwandiwe Sobuwa.
I have this space and has given me so much purpose. Allow me to impact the lives of others. Inspiring them by encouraging them to chase their dreams and
And of course, joining me right now, earlier on the competition, if you were here, you would have seen that we had our winner for the best community engagement project, and they're right here with me. And of course, joining them is community engagement specialist Tepo Pride and Melissa, who handles the social media things there by, of course, a community engagement. Now, I'm going to start with you, my queen, winning that award. What did it mean to you?
A lot to me because it's something that is very close to my heart. I grew up in it and it has transformed my life. So I wanted to bring it here at UJ to transform more students' lives.
I absolutely love that. Now for someone who was not here tonight, what it is that is your community engagement project?
My community engagement initiative is reviving the UJ Ballroom and Latin Dance Club.
Absolutely loving that, and that's why she is, of course, your Miss Best Community Engagement Project. Now moving on to my guy, Edgar. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling great, man.
We're feeling good for you as well. Now talk to me. You are the winner of the Best Community Project, Community Engagement Project on the male side of things. Tell us about your Community Engagement Project for somebody who was not here tonight.
Thank you. Thank you. My Community Engagement Project is the Bridge of Hope, and the Bridge of Growth, what it does is it aim to inspire young children to being great human beings, to being great men, to being great scholars. That's what it's all about.
Absolutely love that. Now I want to move to you, Tepo Pride. I want you to tell me, as a specialist at community engagement, what it is that you were looking at when you were choosing the winners for this particular award.
Thank you very much for that question. Actually, what we were looking at, we're actually looking at the strategy for the University of Johannesburg, which talks about societal impact. And in terms of the project, what we looked at, does it actually answers that in terms of where the university is actually gearing up? And looking at the two projects that the gentleman and the lady actually presented, it actually addresses that. And in terms of sustainability, because we are not only looking for a project that is done and then there's no change and there's no sustainability around it.
Absolutely loving that. And I want to know about the impact of social media, Melissa, as a person, you know, who specializes in that. When, you know, promoting this beautiful community engagement project, what role does social media play?
Social media helps us spread the word, and then we are able to have more people engage with UJ community engagement, and therefore more projects are being spread and more people are taking part in the projects, which now makes everybody want to join community engagement because community engagement is fun. So if you're not in community engagement, what are you doing?
What are you doing with your life, right? So all of us at once, we're going to say community engagement in 3, 2, 1, community engagement.
I'd like to welcome to the fourth, Nkhumise. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. The second one being Onkemetse. Now, these ladies have presented their project. As you can see, it's beauty and it also focuses on societal impact. Now, I would like to announce the winner for community engagement project in terms of the ladies. And the winner is Onkemetse. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations to our winners so far. We're moving on.
And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen, coming to you from the Mr. and Miss UJ APK 2023 pageant. I am Uzethembi Nqunqule Shama, PO President Abakhala Madoda Khala Bafazi. Bye.